प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन। इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ब्लड एंड इट्स कॉम्पोनेंट्स। दिस एंटायर सेशन इज ऑल अबाउट द प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन्स। ओके, हेलो, हाई एवरी वन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन। In our last lecture, we already discussed about the blood and its components. This entire session is all about the plasma proteins, okay? So, if I talk about the plasma proteins, okay, what are the compositions of plasma proteins in plasma? So, the composition is 6 to 8 gram per 100 ml of plasma. This is the normal value of plasma proteins in the plasma, okay? How we differentiated the plasma proteins into the four categories with the help of ultracentrifugation methods or with the help of the electrophoresis method, okay? So there are four type of plasma proteins which is present in the plasma. The one is your albumin, the second is your globulin, and the third one is your fibrinogen, and the last is your prothrombin, okay? So these are the plasma proteins which is present in the plasma. So if we talk about the concentration, which one having most concentration in plasma? So albumin is the most abundant plasma protein. It is the most abundant plasma protein, and their volume is about 55%. Okay, 55%. And already we discussed about the AG ratio. The albumin is to globulin ratio. What is the normal AG ratio we have in our body? This is your 1.7:1. But if someone is diagnosed with any medical condition, so this value goes up, goes irregular. Okay, upar niche ho jata hai thoda. Like हमने करा था ब्लड में ब्लड कॉम्पोनेंट्स एंड प्लाज्मा प्रेजेंट होते हैं विद द हेल्प ऑफ सेंट्रीफिकेशन मेथड. सिमिलरली प्लाज्मा में वॉट प्रोटीन्स आर प्रेजेंट, सो वी डू अ टेस्ट विच इज योर अल्ट्रा सेंट्रीफिकेशन एंड द इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस. ओके, सो वॉट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ एल्ब्यूमिन, ग्लोबुलिन, फिब्रिनोजन एंड द प्रोथ्रोम्बिन? Albumin is the most abundant type of a plasma protein, and their volume is about 55%, and it is the smallest protein. It is the smallest protein. Okay, next we talk about the globulin. Globulin have three types. We have alpha globulin, beta globulin and the gamma globulin. Alpha and beta globulin, they are responsible for transport of vitamins. Okay, which type of vitamins? Fat soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins in our body, they are transported by the help of alpha and beta globulin. We have two type of vitamins in our body. The one is fat soluble and another is your water soluble. Fat soluble vitamins is your ADEC, vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K. Vitamin B and C, these are the water soluble vitamins, okay? So this alpha and beta globulin, they are responsible for the transport of fat soluble vitamins, okay? Gamma globulin function we will discuss, okay? Fibrinogen and prothrombin, these are inactive proteins. These are what? These are the inactive protein, and it is responsible for the blood clotting. Okay, so during the time of blood clotting, what happened? This fibrinogen converted into the fibrin. Ek final stage hoti hai jisme ye fibrinogen kisme convert hota hai? It converted into a fibrin. Fibrin is a thread like structure which stop the clotting, and yahi hota hai jo scum banata hai aapke kisi bhi wound ke upar. Okay, so now you know that blood have a viscosity. Blood ka apna ek gaadapan hai. Blood is viscous. So why blood is viscous? This fibrinogen, it play a very important role in the blood viscosity. Okay, so blood is viscous because they have fibrinogen. Fibrinogen, see, viscosity is depending on the shape and size of protein. Okay, viscosity pe kis pe depend karegi? Shape and size of the proteins. And fibrinogen have fibrillar protein which is responsible for providing the viscosity of blood. And viscosity of blood is also provided by the RBC because these are the most evident one. Prothrombin, they are also play an important role in the blood clotting. Okay, these are the functions of this fibrinogen and the prothrombin. Next, we talk about the gamma globulin function. The first is, immunoglobulins are what? Immunoglobulins are the type of gamma globulin and they produce the antibodies. Okay, they produce what? They produce the antibodies. Whenever we have any pathogen infection, so these immunoglobulin makes what? Makes the antibodies against the pathogen. So they provides what? They provides the immunity. Which type of immunity they are providing? Humoral immunity. कौन सी इम्यूनिटी प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं ये हमको? ह्यूमरल इम्यूनिटी प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं. द नेक्स्ट इज हीम एग्लुटिनिन. हीम एग्लुटिनिन इज ऑल्सो अ टाइप ऑफ गामा ग्लोबुलिन विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ब्लड ग्रुप. दिस हीम एग्लुटिनिन प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ब्लड ग्रुप. Okay, and it also makes a ABO system. Okay, what it forms? It forms the ABO system. In humans, in mammals, we have four type of blood group. The blood group A, the blood group B, the blood group AB, and the blood group O. A1 have different antigens, B1 have different antigens, okay? And this antigen is formed by this heme agglutinin, okay? They determine the blood group. Agar aap galti se B blood group A mein transfer karoge, so there is a reaction going on. Why? Because B blood group have antigen B, but they produce antibodies against the A blood group, okay? If this is the A blood group of a person, so they have antigen A, and they makes antibodies B, okay? Similarly, B blood group have antigen B and they forms antibodies B, A. Okay, next we have AB blood group. They have antigen A and they have antigen B, but they are not forming any antibodies, okay? Antibody is nil in the AB blood group, okay? O blood group have no antigen on the surface of RBC and they have anti-A and they also have anti-B, okay? The blood group system we will discuss in our next video, okay? So my purpose is that here, hemagglutinins are formed what? They are forming the different antigens on the surface of your RBC. Okay, next we have glycoproteins. What is glycoprotein? Glycoprotein is nothing, means the carbohydrate is conjugated with the protein. Glyco, what we are using for what? The carbohydrate, okay? So, you know that your cell membrane is made up of the lipid layer, okay? So, on the surface of the cell membrane, which type of gamma globulin is present? This is your glycoprotein. The next we have lipoproteins. So this lipoprotein, they play a very important role in what? They play a very important role in the fat metabolism. Okay, fat examples of your lipoproteins are LDL, okay, low density lipoproteins, high density lipoprotein, which is your HDL, VLDL, very low density lipoproteins, and is your chylomicrons. Okay, these LDL, HDL, VLDL and chylomicron, these are the examples of your lipoproteins, and lipoproteins are the part of your gamma globulin. Okay, chylomicron play a very important role of the transportation of fat from the intestinal lumen to the liver. Okay, this is the function of your chylomicron. Next, these transferrin and the ceruloplasmin, these both are the protein binding, okay? These both are what? These both are the protein binding one, okay? This transferrin, it is bind with the hemoglobin. It is bind with what? It is bind with the, not hemoglobin, sorry, it is bind with the iron. transferrin bind to the iron and ceruloplasmin it is bind to the copper and they transport the iron and the copper in entire blood. Okay, so next transferrin it is bind to iron and transport the iron in entire blood. Okay, next the ceruloplasmin we have, which is the copper binding protein. Ceruloplasmin is what? It is the copper binding protein. It binds to the copper and transport the copper in entire blood. Okay, and copper play a very important role in maintain the energy and also provide strength to the bone. The next we have angiotensinogen. During the time of renin mechanism, this angiotensinogen converted into the angiotensin. Okay, this angiotensinogen converted into the angiotensin, which play a very important role in maintaining of blood pressure. It maintains what? It maintains the blood pressure. Next we have coagulation factors. Many of the coagulation factors are formed by the gamma globulin. Okay, prothrombin and fibrinogen, these are different. Next we have, if somebody have a kidney damage issue, okay, as I told you, albumin is the most evident protein and their volume is 55% and this is the smallest. Okay, if somebody have a kidney damage issue, okay, so what happened during the kidney damage, this albumin is found in the urine because uski kidney damage ho gayi hai. Now pehle albumin pass nahi ho raha tha filtration membrane mein se, now it easily pass into the filtration membrane and comes into the urine, and this condition is known as the albuminuria. Okay, this condition is known as the albuminuria. Okay, and since albumin, what is albuminuria? Presence of albumin protein where? In the urine. And also albumin is decreases in body now because it comes in the urine, and when albumin level goes low in our body, this condition is known as the hypoalbuminemia. Okay, this condition is known as the hypoalbuminemia. And this hypoalbuminemia condition seen in the kidney damage and in the liver damage. Okay, why in the liver damage? Because all plasma proteins, where it is formed in the liver. Okay, write this point, main bhool gayi. Plasma proteins formed where? It is produced in your liver. Okay, and this gamma globulin, it is produced by the plasma cell. Okay, this gamma globulin, it is produced by the plasma cells. All plasma proteins formed in the liver or produced in the liver, but this gamma globulin, it is produced by the plasma cell. Okay, so agar kisi ko kidney damage issue hai to albumin liver mein urine mein mil raha hai. This condition is known as the albuminuria. Ab body mein albumin ka level kam ho raha hai, us condition ko bolenge hypoalbuminemia. Okay, the decrease amount of albumin in the body. And since agar kisi ka liver hi damage ho gaya, liver mein proteins ban rahe hain, to tab bhi ye condition hogi. Okay, and also albumin play a very important role in the oncotic pressure. Oncotic pressure is maintained by the albumin protein. Why? See here, there is a Starling force which exerted on your blood vessels. Okay, so what happens, suppose this is your artery, and suppose this is your vein. Okay, arteries and veins both are merged by the capillaries. Yes or no? Suppose this is your vein and suppose this is your arteries. These arteries and veins both are merged by what? Both are merged by the capillaries. Okay, And capillaries are always found near the tissues because it is very easy to exchange the substance. So here what is present? Here your interstitial fluid is present. Suppose this is the interstitial fluid. Okay, this is the interstitial fluid. And in this capillaries, there is water and the nutrition and there is a protein present. But which protein is present? Albumin protein present in major amount and it maintains the oncotic pressure. Oncotic pressure is maintained by the Starling force. Okay, oncotic pressure is maintained by what? It is maintained by the Starling force. What is a Starling force? There is four type of pressure which maintains the oncotic pressure and collectively they are known as the Starling force. Okay, collectively they are known as what? They are known as the Starling force. Okay, so what are these? Hydrostatic capillary pressure we have. Okay, hydrostatic capillary pressure we have. Osmotic capillary pressure. Then we have hydrostatic interstitial pressure, and then we have hydrostatic osmotic pressure. Okay, these four forces exerted on your blood vessels which maintains the oncotic pressure, and these four forces collectively they are known as the Starling force. Very important. So hydrostatic capillary pressure, it is the pressure of filtration. Okay, it exerted on your capillaries and it is responsible for the filtration. It takes all the water inside the interstitial fluid. Okay, now osmotic capillary pressure, it is the pressure of absorption. It collects the waters or important nutrient from the interstitial fluid and absorb into where? Absorb into the capillaries. Okay, अगर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक कैपिलरी प्रेशर लग रहा है तो वो इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड का पानी क्या करेगा? कैपिलरी से बाहर की तरफ फेंकेगा. बट व्हेन ऑस्मोटिक कैपिलरी प्रेशर इज एक्सर्टेड ऑन कैपिलरीज, वो क्या करेगी? वो यहाँ का इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड का जो वाटर न्यूट्रिशियंट होंगे और प्रोटीन्स, उन्हें उठा के कहाँ लेकर आएगी? कैपिलरीज के अंदर लेकर आएगी. दिस इज द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ ऑस्मोटिक कैपिलरी प्रेशर. अब नाउ दिस हाइड्रोस्टेटिक इंटरस्टिशियल प्रेशर, अब जो हाइड्रोस्टेटिक इंटरस्टिशियल प्रेशर होता है, अब हाइड्रोस्टेटिक इंटरस्टिशियल प्रेशर भी इंटरस्टिशियल के फ्लूइड को कहाँ देता है? कैपिलरीज में देता है. एंड हाइड्रोस्टेटिक ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर जब लगता है तो ये जो यहाँ पर प्रोटीन्स और वाटर होते हैं इनको कहाँ उठाकर लेकर आता है? इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड में वापस लेकर आता है. अगर इनमें से एक भी फोर्स कम या ज़्यादा हुआ, इट डिस्टर्ब्स द ऑन्कोटिक प्रेशर. ओके, एंड मेनली ऑन्कोटिक प्रेशर इज determined by the albumin. If somebody have a kidney damage or liver damage issues, so albumin protein is not present here. So all the waters, it got accumulated into the interstitial region, which result is edema. क्या होगा अगर एल्ब्यूमिन नहीं होगा? बिकॉज इट मेंटेन्स द ऑस्मोलैरिटी हेयर ना. बट वेन द ऑस्मोल एल्ब्यूमिन प्रोटीन इज एबसेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द कंडीशन लाइक हाइपो एल्ब्यूमिन ईमिया. सो हाइपो एल्ब्यूमिन ईमिया लाइक कंडीशन में क्या होगा? इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड गॉट एक्यूमुलेटेड इन टू द बॉडी टिश्यू, विच रिजल्ट इज एडिमा. ओके, एडिमा इज मीन्स स्वेलिंग होगी. दैट्स वाई जिनका लीवर और किडनी के इश्यूज होते हैं उनके आप फीट पे स्वेलिंग देख सकते हो. ओके, फिर पैर सूज हुए मिलेंगे एंड यू कैन नोटिस दिस स्वेलिंग ऑन देयर फेस. ओके, क्योंकि पानी इकट्ठा होने लगता है इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड में. सो दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ योर स्टार्लिंग फोर्स और दैट्स हाउ एल्ब्यूमिन मेंटेन्स द ऑन्कोटिक प्रेशर. एंड द नेट प्रेशर, कितना प्रेशर लगना चाहिए? विच इज योर 25 mm of mercury. Okay, which is your next we have the pressures. The next is your maintain. It maintains what? It maintains your oncotic pressure. Okay, and oncotic pressure is your 25 mm of mercury. Next, it provides immunity. Gamma globulin forms the immunity na and provides what? It provides the humoral type of immunity. It help in coagulation of blood because they have clotting factor, and fibrinogen and prothrombin play a very important role in your coagulation. In next video, we will going to discuss about the mechanism of coagulation. Next, it provides viscosity of blood. As I told you, fibrinogen provide viscous nature to blood because viscosity is depend on the shape and size of protein, and fibrinogen contains the fibrillar type of protein. It acts as a buffer. It maintains the pH of our blood and also maintains the pH of our body. It plays a very important role in the metabolism because it is responsible for the fat metabolism, like your chylomicron or the lipoproteins, okay? And it also maintains the what? It is also responsible for determination of ESR. What is ESR? Erythrocyte sedimentation rate. Okay, this is what? This is erythrocyte sedimentation rate. Agar somebody have a inflammatory like disease, so ESR rate will going to be increases. ESR routine checkup test में भी आता है. अगर किसी की body में infection होता है तो ESR का rate increase हो जाता है. Inflammation की वजह से ESR rate will going to be increase. Okay? And also अब हम जब tablet देते हैं person को तो ESR का rate कम होने लगता है because inflammation जा रही है. तो हम ESR का test routine checkup में कराते हैं. क्यों कराते हैं? देखने के लिए कि जो हम medicine दे रहे हैं patient को वो actually work कर भी रही है या नहीं. अगर ESR का rate नहीं घट रहा, that means medicines not work. Yes or no? Medicine are not working. But if it ESR rate going to decreases, that means medicine work on the patient's body. ESR में क्या करती हैं? When we have a centrifuge method, इनमें उसमें हम क्या करते थे? Fastly rotate करते थे. But हम यहाँ पर ऐसे नहीं करते. Test tube होती है. Test tube में blood collect करते हैं patient का. ठीक है? यहाँ blood collect करेंगे और उसे एक घंटे के लिए छोड़ देंगे. After 1 hour हम यहाँ पर देखते हैं कि कितनी speed से जो RBC के cells हैं वो यहाँ पर settle down हुए हैं. क्योंकि RBC they are more in number and they have a हाई स्पीड, यस और नो? तो आरबीसी यहाँ पर जल्दी गिरते हैं. तो हम देखते हैं कि एक घंटे में कितने आरबीसी यहाँ पर गिरे हैं, उसी को एरिथ्रोसाइट सेडिमेंटेशन रेट बोलते हैं कि एक आवर में कितने एरिथ्रोसाइट यहाँ पर सेडिमेंट हुआ है. बिकॉज व्हेन समबडी हैव अ इन्फ्लामेटरी डिसीज और दे हैव अ इन्फ्लामेशन इन देयर बॉडी, सो दे मेक्स मोर प्रोटीन्स इन दी बॉडी. इन द केस ऑफ इन्फ्लामेशन मोर प्रोटीन्स फॉर्म्ड इन दी बॉडी एंड एरिथ्रोसाइट की स्पीड और भी तेज हो जाती है. इसलिए हम यहाँ पर ESR का रेट चेक करते हैं. ओके, सो दीज आर दी फंक्शंस ऑफ योर प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन्स. इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दी मैकेनिज्म ऑफ कोगुलेशन एंड ऑल्सो वी डिस्कस अबाउट दी ABO ब्लड ग्रुप सिस्टम एंड RH सिस्टम. ओके, दैट्स इट फॉर द टुडे. द रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन अवर नेक्स्ट सेशन. बाय, टेक केयर.